I've been seeing a lot of videos. I've been watching a lot of videos actually recently, on people's crystal collections, and I thought that I would make a video showcasing some of the crystals and things that I have collected over a couple years. The first thing I want to really showcase is, I guess, all of the go from like least favorite to most favorite. So I'll showcase. I have a nice piece of blue quartz here. It's pretty sweet. It's smaller than I would like it to be, but it's polished stone, so you can't really expect it to be very big. Also have a piece of garnet here. This one's bigger than the blue quartz. It's hard to see with the lighting, but it's actually a dark red. So that's nice. I like this one a lot. And then, now this isn't my only piece of citrine that I have. This one's the polished stone kind. You can't really see the orange in this lighting. It's hard to see, but it's orange. This one's the polished stone kind. I usually keep that on display. I usually keep all my points more, I don't know, guess not out in the open. This one here is polished stone as well. This one's pretty sure it's aquamarine. Yeah. This one's aquamarine. This polished stone again, I keep this one on display. Okay, this is my smoky quartz piece here. And again, it's polished. I usually just keep the polished stones out because, you know, if people want to touch them or mess with them, that's fine. My points and stuff like that, I keep, you know, tucked away so that no one will mess with them. I also have, this is probably my favorite polished stone that I've collected and found. And actually, when I bought this, I was not aware that this was going to be this good. I thought it was going to be all one solid color. This is fluorite, and I don't know if you can see, but it's actually two-tone. It's a dark purple over here, and then down here is more of a green color. So, and it's fairly see-through as well. And I don't know if y'all can see that. It's a very nice crystal. It's good to use for meditation. I really enjoy this crystal. I keep this one out too. This is kind of like the centerpiece, if you will. Very proud of this being a polished stone too. It'd been beautiful if it was a natural point, but you know, I'll take it, you know, if I can only get it in polished stone. I just have two pieces of tumbled quartz. I tend to try to stay away from tumbled things. I have a lot of tumbled things, but that's just for my collection that I keep on display. So yeah, this is nothing fancy, just some clear quartz. It's tumbled stone. Now we're gonna get into my points here. So this is probably one of my favorite points. It's very small, but it's Aqua Aura, and it's in its natural like point state. It's very beautiful, very blue. It's very see-through as well, so it's very nice, very transparent. This is amazing. I've been considering turning it into a pendant, wearing it on my neck or something, but you know, I almost don't want to do that just for the fear of it falling off or getting lost or you know, damaged. So I usually keep this one tucked away fairly well. Next point is small as well, but it's a little bit bigger than the Aqua Aura. So here's the Aqua Aura. Here is a small point of Lemurian seed crystal. This one is not Starberry Lemurian seed crystal. This is just a regular Lemurian seed crystal. This one I'm actually considering turning into a pendant because it's fairly small. It's my smaller Lemurian seed crystal, and it's very formed, flat on the bottom, and a very nice point up top. So, you know, this one would be pretty good for wearing around my neck. So I've been considering turning that one into a pendant. Now, this is my other piece of citrine. Here's my citrine, tumbled stone that showed you guys. This one here is my natural citrine point. I got this one online from this woman that sells crystals. She gets them from a dealer. And this one caught my eye because of the fact that it's fairly decent size actually for what I saw from other places. So I don't know if you can see that, but this is it's gold, it's brownish orange up top, and then it's white on the bottom where the natural it was sitting probably on a cluster. So it was probably a cluster and it was probably sticking out and they were able to get that piece off. I like this a lot actually. It's very nice. It's good to meditate with as well. I don't know if y'all can see that, but there's the orange color there. So I like this one quite a bit. All right, next, I have a same woman that I bought these crystals from, or this point from. I usually buy my natural points from her. Her name is, or okay. Her website is crystal-cure.com, Emily Gems, and very, very helpful. I enjoy doing business with her a lot, so I'll probably be getting a lot more for my collection in the future with her. But this is a piece of clear crystal quartz that I got, and it's a point, crystal point, but it's two that are actually connected, so it's kind of like I got this like two for one, I guess, if you will. I like this one a lot. It's in its very natural state, and I like the fact that you can see the bottom here is very matted. It's matte finish, and then it slowly clears up the closer you get to the points. So that's very I like this a lot. All right, and then this is more one of more my more clear. Clear quartz, translucent pieces. This is a natural point again. I like this one a lot because it's got an interesting facet to it. So on the sides, all the sides are pretty much clear except for this one very large flat edge, which is very matted finish, and it's the only side of this that has that. I don't know what it is about it, but it's pretty cool, and it's a fairly decent size as well. So these two, I got together. On another occasion, I found this one. The thing that really interested me with this is this is another piece of clear crystal quartz and its natural point state. And the thing that really caught my eye about this was, well, here it is facing upwards. It looks like your average everyday piece of crystal quartz, but the bottom of it is the very, very bottom edge here. You can see where it was connected to some cluster. It's very, so you literally have from like very bottom of almost its root, I guess you could say, to the very tip, all like right here. And I love the way that it's very foggy down here, and it works its way up to being completely clear. So you can see my finger through it. So I like this piece a lot. This is probably my favorite small clear quartz crystal that's not Lemurian seed. So this is probably my favorite one. And then the pièce de résistance is my Lemurian seed crystal that I have. It's in its natural, point state. And I got this from an auction that was going on, and it was Lemurian sea crystals. You're lucky, it's easy to find stuff like this. This is considered an average size. This is the normal size you could probably buy for a Lemurian sea crystal. So when I saw this Lemurian sea crystal and the size of it, I immediately felt drawn to try to win it in this auction. And a lot of people were going after it. And it eventually got to the point where the auction was getting so high, some people were starting to just drop off and I guess quit. And I just knew that I had to have this. The striations on this are very prominent, very prominent. And I would have liked, I've checked all over it. Maybe I'm just missing it, I don't know. But I was hoping that this would be a strawberry crystal, and you know, has the hieroglyphs on it, but it doesn't, as far as I can tell right now. However, this is a very nice crystal, and its size is very, very nice, way bigger than I expected it to be from the pictures. But yeah, I got this for $122, I believe, and I got it through an online dealer. Through an auction site, and here it is. This is my Lemurian seed crystal. So you can clearly see the striations here on this side, and their striations follow the normal Lemurian seed crystal striation pattern, where you have one side of striation, then you look here, very shiny. Then another side of striations. And then a very clear, smooth side, another side of striations, and it does that. So there should be three sides that have striations, and these striations are very, very prominent. I don't know if, there you go. So, yeah, you can see the lines that are distinctive to the Lemurian seed crystals. Almost acts as if they're stairs or something. So yeah, this is very, very much my favorite piece. Out of all of my crystals, it's very powerful. It even people that aren't into energies and working with crystals or meditation or anything like that, chakras, can feel the energy of Lemurian seed crystal. There's something about it that, you know, really sets it apart from other quartz and other crystals and points. The thing about Lemurian seed crystals are that they were found in the sands of a beach. And this is from what I've read, and this is what I believe the origins of a real legitimate 100% Lemurian seed crystal is. And it was found in the sands of a beach. And you know, for a normal crystal to grow, like for example this one, it needs to come from somewhere. A crystal doesn't just grow on your porch and all of a sudden you have a crystal there. It needs to have a starting point, something to grow on. Well, the Lemurian seed crystals were just found laying in sand, a whole bunch of them, and from Brazil, or in Brazil. And so clearly, there's something about this that, you know, sets it apart from other crystals. A lot of people think the striations are messages left by the ancient Lemurian people. And others think they look like barcodes, which again, barcodes hold information, so they very well could be. But as far as, you know, what I think, I feel that the energy is so strong that it can't just have been a coincidence that they were just laying by themselves, you know, just laying there in the sand. So I feel like there's something about these crystals that were intended to be found. And the mystery behind it is enough alone to want to, for someone to want to, you know, try to get their hands on one. But in order to find a very authentic one, your best bet is to go through Brazilian dealers, any dealers that have legitimate reference points from where they get their crystals and things like that. But yeah, I will put links down below for the Crystal Cure site, as well as any other links that I can recover from where I've gotten my other crystals. And if you guys have a favorite crystal you think that I should check out, or should, you know, invest in, let me know, and I will definitely check it out and see if I can't find a way to obtain one. So that is a small part of my huge crystal collection that I have. A lot of the things I haven't showcased because I just don't feel that there's much to say about them. But yeah, definitely. I would say for anyone that's interested in crystals, start off with some clear quartz or something. They're very powerful. But you know, try to get your hands on a piece of Lemurian seed crystal. You know, if you can, you will not regret it at all. They're worth the price. They're very strong crystals, and their energy just is mind-blowing, actually. Like holding it, you can feel the vibrations, not literal vibrations. You can feel the energy radiating off of it. It's a very strong crystal. So I'd recommend that everyone tries to get their hand on at least clear quartz, if not Lemurian seed crystal. So anyways, that's my video on crystal collection. I will probably be doing more videos about this if this seems to be a popular video. And everyone have a good day and blessed be.